Stabilize her mood swings, but she didn't like the medication. she was a runaway. This report was only 6 sentences long. It basically stated that she had left the house around 7 p.m. on September 14th and never returned. She was a 15-year-old girl with blonde hair and blue eyes. It also stated that she had been diagnosed with a mental disorder, possibly bipolar disorder. And that's pretty much all her missing persons report says. From what Cassie's mother told police, they believed she was very upset and angry when she left, and they thought she had just run away and they would be able to track her down and bring her home. Cassie had, in fact, run away a handful of times in the past. She would be gone for a day or two before just turning back up. Now, Cassie was not living in a happy situation. Her home life was pretty bad. She had expressed to her friends how bad it was at home, and so, again, it just seems like she's a moody teenager who ran away. Now, the chief of police did say that just because her original missing persons report was only a few sentences does not mean that they did not fully investigate the case. He said that her case file is extremely thick and they have followed up on every single tip that has come in. So, Cassie was homeschooled at the time she went missing. Her mother tells police she's possibly bipolar or suffering from depression. However, police would later say she was never officially diagnosed or treated for bipolar or depression by a physician. So this is kind of where some of those discrepancies come in. Because Cassie was homeschooled, or supposed to be being homeschooled, there really was no one to watch out for Cassie, keep an eye on her. There were no teachers or school counselors that she could confide in. And like I said, her home situation was bad. While police first believed Cassie had run away due to her history of running away, there were some other possibilities that were not looked into right away during those, like, crucial first 72 hours. And the neighborhood where Cassie lived wasn't super great. There was an abandoned house next door that apparently someone had been squatting in, and there were 20 registered sex offenders living nearby. In fact, one living in Cassie's home, which we'll talk about in just a minute. And a neighbor reportedly noticed a white van loitering around the neighborhood in the days before Cassie went missing. After Cassie's case kind of got picked up by the media, there were rumors saying that she was living in a Stuttgart apartment with her boyfriend. Police did investigate this, and there was a woman who looked a lot like Cassie, except this woman was not Cassie. She was 25 years old. When Cassie went missing, Brandon Rhodes, which was Cassie's mom's boyfriend or fiance, was living with them at the time. So when the couple is first talking to police, Brandon always seemed to sex offender. registry list in Oklahoma for over 20 years. According to her, her ex-husband had been sexually assaulting their daughter. And because of this, she was charged with a failure to protect her child. She said she was forced into a plea deal, even though she claims she had nothing to know about this abuse. So all of this happened before Cassie was born, so this is why law enforcement was familiar with the family. And this is another reason why Cassie had such a rough home life. While Brandon Rhodes seems to be the most likely suspect in the case, police have never come right out and named him as a prime suspect. Now, Judy and Brandon were both given polygraphs as soon as Cassie went missing, and they both failed them. Now, Judy would later say she had arthritis. She would use pain patches to deal with this constant pain, and because of the, like, effects of her pain patch on her body, that was why she had failed. However, once Cassie went missing and they were both given these polygraphs and Brandon failed his, this was when Judy broke up with him, and I think she really started to believe he had something to do with Cassie's disappearance. When Cassie first went missing, her mother always said that her and Brandon had a great relationship, but we know that was not the case. After they broke up, Brandon left town and had a series of run-ins with the law. He had a lot of stuff on his criminal record, including theft, driving without a license, unlawful possession of a firearm, conspiracy to commit delivery of methamphetamines. He had affiliations with different gangs, and the kicker, he was arrested for conspiracy to commit capital murder. Brandon, however, continues to deny his involvement in Cassie's disappearance, and there's nothing at this point that can, like, prove he was. Years after Cassie went missing, her mother, Judy, opened up about what had really happened the night Cassie went missing. And this time, she told a different story, or at least maybe a more complete story. She said that Cassie's friend Hunter brought her home that evening, and Judy had been sick in bed. Brandon was in the kitchen making pancakes for dinner. Cassie went into the home but never spoke to her mother. Now, originally, from what I read, she had told police that she had spoke to her daughter, so again, a lot of inconsistencies, which is kind of difficult to give you all the information when there's all these different stories. But anyway, this time she says she never spoke to her daughter. She changed her clothes and decided to go for a walk. Cassie then texted her friend Hunter saying she was gonna go for a smoke. But 15-year-old Cassie cannot legally buy cigarettes. Around this time, Brandon goes into Judy's room, grabs something, and says he's going to run to the gas station to buy cigarettes. So here's a theory. They both left the house saying they were gonna buy cigarettes or go for a smoke. Brandon told Judy he was gonna go buy them. Cassie texts her friend that she's gonna go smoke. Was it possible these two actually left the house together? Because now, according to Judy, she never saw her daughter leave. Brandon left in Judy's car. And then, I guess at the time, they both lied to police about this. person said he had left on a bicycle because he did not have a valid driver's license and he didn't want to get in trouble for driving without a driver's license. This seems super suspicious to me because there is a missing child, so your little driving without a license charge should not seem like a big enough deal to make up a lie about. So I think that is super suspicious. I also think he lied to kind of throw suspicion away from himself. If he's on a bike, it's very unlikely he could have done something to Cassie and then, like, moved her body on a bicycle with no one watching or without anyone seeing. However, had police known right away he had left in a vehicle, maybe they would have been able to search that vehicle for, like, DNA or blood or something like that. Anyway, when he returned home, he told Judy he was sick, and then he went in the bathroom and stayed in the bathroom for almost 2 hours. And this entire time, Judy never got out of bed. So, I believe that part of the reason Cassie was not reported missing the night she went missing, and this is just my opinion, is because her mother never knew she was missing. She never got out of bed. They were not out looking for Cassie like they told the media. They were not out doing anything. To this day, there really hasn't been anything for police to go off of. No leads, no one has come forward with information. Police say the closest lead they have is Brandon Rhodes. And while police have never been able to, like, officially tie him to the disappearance, he is still a person of interest in the case. So, let's go back to that TikTok video that has gone viral. Police were very concerned with the well-being of the woman in the video, and even Cassie's mother told the media she believed it could be Cassie in that TikTok. She told TV Age 11 in Little Rock, quote, "My poor baby. She looks beat up. She looks strung out." Now, this woman in the video later came forward and said her name was Haley Grace Phillips, and she is not Cassie Compton. Haley shared a video on her Instagram that said, in part, quote, "Thank you everybody for worrying, and also thank you for making me post a picture of me recovering of my black eyes. I was robbed this weekend. I'm fine, okay? I am not kidnapped. And this is my phone, and I am real, and this is a real account, so everyone stop bothering me. I am Haley Grace." Now, there has been a family member who has come out to confirm this woman's identity. However, at the time I am filming this, I have not seen anything official released from police. They did release a statement that said, quote, "We appreciate all the tips and information about Cassie Compton. We have the video from TikTok and have seen the Facebook posts. We are working diligently with Arkansas State Police and the FBI right now. This is still an open case and we can't release any further information right now." Now, Colleen Nick from the Morgan Nick Foundation, which, if you follow me or if you're a part of my Patreon, I just covered Morgan Nick's disappearance over there. Anyway, she released a statement that said, quote, "It was breathtaking to watch the concern for the missing teen unfold over the internet," end quote. I completely agree with this statement, and this is why I chose to release this video. While the woman in the TikTok video is saying legitimate interest in the case, and I feel like it is important to get Cassie's story out there. Cassie Compton was around 5'3" tall and weighed 100 pounds when she was last seen. She has blonde hair and blue eyes and a noticeable scar around her neck. Anyone with information about her disappearance should call the Stuttgart Police Department at 1-870-673-1414. Now, I do kind of want to talk a little bit about what I think in this case. And again, these are just my opinions. Feel free to let me know what you think. I 100% think Brandon Rhodes is responsible, and unfortunately I do feel like Cassie's mother knows more than she is letting on. Her changing her story after the fact is suspicious to me. I don't necessarily think she was involved, but I do think she may have been trying to protect Brandon in the beginning. Unfortunately, Cassie came from a bad situation, and I feel like she was kind of like an easy target, which is awful. With this TikTok video, the woman does look like her, and this woman is saying she is not her, and I will respect that. However, she was in a TikTok video. She did put that TikTok video out for the world to see. So, that is why I chose to include it in this video. I'm not trying to give her negative attention, if that makes sense. She did a little more in her video that I left out, where she was basically like, "Everybody leave me alone. I don't know this Cassie Compton bitch." Like, she was very unhappy about the attention she was receiving. And I want to be respectful of that. However, at the same time, she did release the TikTok. So, she's the one that put it out there in the first place. And that is why I chose to include it in this video. I just feel like I may get some backlash for that. So, that is just why I did it. Let me know what you guys think. This was one of the harder cases I've ever had to research because there's so many totally conflicting articles out there, and there's really not a